genome. There's over 20,000 of them. We could look at it in the blink of an eye with the chips and these microarrays. It's like a little piece of a wafer. You know how to go to church and put that thing on your mouth and communion. It's not even bigger than that little wafer. Not even thicker than that. A lot of electronics, we're now able to measure thousands of genes at a time. In tumor or cancer tissue versus normal tissue to see which genes are being on, overexpressed, which ones are being underexpressed, simultaneously. We can actually answer a lot of questions if we have the material, right? And that's where research and these clinical trials come in. Because guess what? The more information we have, the more knowledgeable we can assess the problem, and the more actionable and the more success we can have as clinicians when we in prognosis and treatment. Also, what's important now is increased research in diverse populations. But when you do that, you have to go beyond just somebody saying that they're black, right? You have to integrate population history and epidemiology and cultural history, because it's important. First, blacks in South Carolina, the Gullah Geechee folk, right? You might know Geechees?
Gullah Geechee,
they call it, you know, they're different. They're a little different than them blacks in Mississippi, Louisiana, New Orleans, okay? Which is a little different than even blacks we see in California. Okay, so the point is that there's local experiences that also impact our biology. But when we look at the DNA, we find that African descent populations have a lot more genetic variation than non-African populations. This is very, very important. Because if, in fact, genes play a role in disease risk and drug treatment outcomes, if your genes play a role in what we call drug efficacy, then knowing the amount of genetic variation that's in the population that you're targeting is very, very important. And I'll say that again. Knowing the amount of genetic variation in the population that you're targeting with this drug is very important, because some people may respond better than others, and you want to identify those people. That's called individualized medicine, personalized medicine. The other week I heard somebody say precision medicine. Using knowledge. So now genetics enters clinical practice. Personalized medicine, precision medicine, improves diagnostics, pharmacogenetics, new biology, new drugs, risk assessment. But today I'm going to talk about clinical trials. Because now, these clinical trials, the FDA and a lot of these regulators are now saying, we not only want you to have a diverse population that you're studying, meaning black, white, Hispanic, all of them, but we also want to see at the individual level what those differences are in outcomes. And a lot of times, that's stratified based on genetics. It's just going towards individualized or personalized medicine. Now, why is this so important? Because if you look at this curve here, the red line, that curve, that's the disease process through time. And if we are able to impact the disease process early, we can what? Have better outcomes. The later the diagnosis, the later the treatment, the poorer the outcomes. We know that for pretty much every disease. Catch it early, you're in a much better situation. So how can we do that now? Well, we're using genetics now as decision support tools, assessing risk, refining that assessment, predicting and diagnosing, and then, you know, trying to get that intervention earlier. Because to look at the typical intervention, it's late in the game. You see the arrow where it says typical intervention? That's late. We want to push it to the left, early. Perfect example. Now, you go to some hospitals, this is not all hospitals, this is where, also where the money hits the road, because, you know, a lot of this knowledge and technology isn't readily available to everybody just yet. Which is why there's so much pushback with the Affordable Care Act, because it's trying to level the playing field. Think about what I'm saying. So if you go to certain hospitals, like in the Gold Coast up north, or in certain big university hospitals, and you have cancer, you can get into a clinical trial where they will select you just based randomly, right? And they will look at your tumor and do some genomics, a genomic analysis, and then be able to say something about prediction and prognosis and pharmacogenetics, what drugs will the actual tumor respond to. Those trials are going on now, but they're not going on everywhere. Like, for instance, I don't want to name any hospitals. But you go to certain hospitals in the community, they're not going to have that. Okay? And in order to get in some of those other hospitals, you had to have not only insurance, but you better have good insurance. You know, the Cadillac plans, those Cadillac insurance plans, right? So why should I care? Because we're in this era now of personalized medicine, and it's important because you can take an active role. Genetic tests are currently available. The problem, though, is that genetic medicine may actually increase health disparities because it is linked to economics. If you have the money, you can have the technology, and you have the knowledge. What's also a rate-limiting step here is that most of the information we know about genetics and prediction of and prognosis and pharmacogenetics is based on populations of European descent. Populations of European descent.
Thank you.
Think about what I'm saying. If for 20 years, the genetic research was focused mainly in white European populations, then the knowledge base is based on white folks. So that means that they can be much more actionable in the white community. This is very important. This is why diversity in clinical trials is so very important. In particular now, because some of this information may actually help alleviate some of what we see in terms of health disparities. But if it's not done right and the economics isn't, or the benefits aren't distributed across all populations, it will increase health disparities. One of the other things we know is that genetics alone will not help us. The environment is important. I'll give you an example. You see this here? This is the prevalence of hypertension by mean body mass index in populations in the African diaspora. So if you look on the X axis there where it says body mass index, you'll notice